You're not supposed to do that. Now we wake up. Go, 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 go. Ah! Ah!
Exile's under-17s water polo team have finished bottom of the Maltese League for 3 years running.
Last season, we lost every game except one, which we drew, 4 each.
They haven't won a game in 19 matches.
Sometimes I get used to the fact that we lose.
In the game, when all the pressure comes in, it's like we forget how to play water polo.
Last season, Exiles conceded twice as many goals as their nearest rival.
When you lose by that much, you tend to feel like, ah, should I be playing this sport?
Biggest problem was definitely confidence. Once we come in front of the post, we don't take the good shot and we don't score.
The goals have stopped from here. Less talking, more goals.
Coach Gordon has worked with this group of players for 2 years.
At this point in time, they lost so many games and they were always losing that they feel that it's not possible for them to win.
Hey, I'm not that happy, eh? No, no, no!
We feel like we're letting our coach down because we're training well, but then when we go out to play, we don't sort of show what we have.
I would love them to win. They deserve much more than this. But as a coach, I feel like I don't know what else to do.
Now help is on its way in the shape of triple Olympic gold medalist Tamash Mulner. Tamash is no stranger to Malta. After an illustrious Olympic career, he spent a triumphant 5 seasons with top National League team Neptunes.
I have to tell you, I really love to play here. And I'm still happy I can come back here.
Now he hopes to be able to impart some of his water polo prowess to the Exiles.
They are expecting somebody coming, and I think they will be very surprised when I be the one who will enter the room. I will do my best, and I hope they will get something from my knowledge.
I hope in Malta I don't have to introduce myself to you.
I played 12 years for the Hungarian national team. I have a lot of experience. I have been thinking what to do with you. I have a lot of idea, and I hope with the help of my experience, we will be able to beat Sirens next week. Good?
Water polo is a tough physical sport where fouling is part and parcel of the game, above and below water.
And I would like to see sharks in the water, not jellyfishes.
Tamash wants the players to know the worst they might encounter.
I would like you to just figure out what to do against me.
Tamash is testing the players' courage and strength. By pushing the team, he hopes that they will be able to play with more confidence.
Never been one-to-one with such a strong coach.
The Exiles will need all the belief they can muster if they're to rise up the league table.
Your adrenaline and everything is going up. You would like to win the fight, but it's not a fight, it's a practice. But it was very good. Thank you.
I think it helps a lot to be aggressive, because if you're not aggressive, you're not showing the opponent that you mean business.
Super coach Tamash is encouraged by what he's seen so far.
They got some real experience what real water polo fight is. They didn't hesitate to fight with full power, and this was what I wanted.
It's the second day, and Exiles are training at the national pool. Today, Tamash is focusing on the defence. Last season, Exiles conceded 80 more goals than they scored. Tamash has a couple of drills to help the defender get round the attacker to steal the ball. The first technique is to use the power of the attacker's swim against them.
When you play against a very strong centre forward and he is pushing you toward a goal, let him go. Immediately you can cover.
The second tactic is to move the attacker from side to side before slipping past them.
One side and the arm is out. Push it down, come to the front, and you have to position yourself between the ball and the center forward.
In a highly physical game where much of the action takes place underwater, it can be hard to identify what's strictly legal and what's not. Players need to know how to protect themselves from what might technically be a foul, but in practice can go unseen by the ref. Exiles will need all their defensive skills against Sirens for the big match in 5 days' time. Last time they played them, they lost 16-8.
Every second in the water is precious for our kids. They learn a lot, they really learn a lot.
I tried to play really hard, and it was a bit surprising for them. But they have to understand that water polo is a really tough game, and they have to be tough when they are playing.
Exiles need to start winning if they are to avoid finishing bottom of the league for the fourth year running.
Hop!
Today, their Olympian supercoach is ramping up their training.
Eggbeater on the way back.
Eggbeater is the specialized leg stroke players use to keep their torsos out of the water.
Hop!
It's a physically punishing technique.
Hop. Everybody has four times, four jumps. First, to the side, up, left and right.
Hop!
Tight, imagine there is a ball over there and you would like to reach it.
After working on their stamina, Tamás sets up some passing exercises. He includes one drill designed for speed of body and mind.
It's not about practicing passing. It's rather to improve the concentration.
The players are divided into two teams, alternating in a large circle. The objective is to pass the ball as quickly as possible.
You guys, you have the balls.
Yeah,
and first exercise, you start to the right.
In water polo, you can use only one hand to touch the ball. The passing's not quick enough for Tamás.
If you pass like this, it will take very long. It's a quick movement. All right, that's right. Go. Yeah. It was very good.
Tamás ends the session combining all the techniques he's coached Exiles in today for quick passing and fast shooting.
It was a very good training session because I realized that they are very competitive. They are motivated, they are not lazy, and I can see in the eyes they do what I ask for. So I'm happy, I'm very satisfied now.
I remembered everything that he taught us. I knew exactly what to do. That it's really, it was really, I think it was very useful.
Mom, I'm home.
Ismail has his mum Marlene to thank for his sporting passion.
I introduced him to water polo. He was a chubby boy. Now he trains all week. I like to see him training, and now I'm very proud of him.
These are all pictures of me from when I was little. I read a lot of books, as you can see. These are my study books.
Ismail has very specific life goals.
My dreams in life are basically playing water polo and, well, succeeding in obtaining physiotherapy as a job. Money and fun, it's all I need. Well, a girlfriend would be nice too.
He's prepared to work hard to fulfill his ambitions.
What I love about water polo, the endless sweat you have to put in to get everything perfect. You have to think of the tactic that you're doing whilst you're getting punched in the face. It's very hard. And that's why I like it. I like a challenge. We've always been the underdogs of Malta. We really want to make our mark on the island.
It's Exiles' final training session before their big game against league rivals Sirens. After a warm-up swim across St. Julian's Bay, Olympic gold medalist Tamás Molnár has one last scenario he wants to rehearse with the team. Man up. Where an opposing player is sent off, usually for 20 seconds, sometimes up to 4 minutes, for committing a serious foul. 70% of goals are scored while a team is man up.
Luca.
Gordon gives white caps to the man-up team. Six attackers attempting to score against five defenders, including an Olympian.
I'll be playing defense. They will try to do their best against me for sure. So it's a big motivation.
Be at top of position, please. Light the game.
Exiles have several tactics to maximize the temporary advantage being man-up offers.
Luca, Mikel on you.
Tamás is defending hard, but some of Exile's plays are getting through. The supercoach has given the team new confidence for tomorrow's game.
You cannot pinpoint exactly that, you know, he did this and we're doing this and it's going to win us the game. It's more the feeling that he was there. It's like it's a boost in confidence that we can actually win this.
Everything that he told me, I tried it during training. And now, tomorrow, I will apply it for the game.
I think we've got a pretty good shot of winning the game.
Tamás can do no more.
I think Exiles is a better team than Cybrians, but you have to prove it tomorrow in the pool as well.
It's the day of the big game against Sirens, a team Exiles under-17s haven't beaten in 4 years. It was to be a home fixture for Exiles, but rough seas have meant the match will be played at the Sirens' home pitch, a 30-minute drive away.
Hello, everybody.
You lose the advantage when you play away, slightly, but if you want to win, you have to win every game.
This is Tamás's last chance to reinforce the team's self-belief.
Don't be scared, don't be nervous. You cannot win the game by yourself, but you have to add your part. All right? Good luck.
As is tradition for the visiting team, Exiles play in blue caps. Water polo is played over 4 quarters of 8 minutes.
I believe in them.
Each quarter starts with a swim sprint.
Stand up.
The first few minutes are cautious.
Oh, no problem. At least it went to the line.
Then a foul gives Exiles a huge opportunity. A punch in the face is deemed a brutal foul. The Sirens player is sent off.
It's a good chance to make 2-3 goals. Bravo! We have to use our chances now.
Exiles have 80 seconds of man-up remaining, but they don't seem to be taking advantage of it.
Man up, Luca! Luca!
You don't have to be in a hurry.
I want a goal. Let's get a goal.
Even playing man-up for 4 minutes, Exiles have failed to score. The first quarter ends with a fragile lead, 1-0 to Exiles. In the second quarter, there's a sudden flurry of action.
Go, go!
First, Sirens equalise. Exiles come back. And then Sirens level the game again. The half ends 2-2.
It's half-time 2-2. We have our opportunities.
Just 2 minutes into the second half.
Gianni!
Exiles find themselves in a familiar position. Losing. Yes. They need to believe they can turn it around. There's a glimmer of hope as Luca gets into a shooting position. His goal pulls Exiles back level.
The score is 3-3. We have to take back the lead.
There's a penalty, and Luca is up again. But Sirens are not done yet. In defence, the Exiles are remembering everything Tamás has taught them.
Yeah, bravo, Andrew. You can go, go.
Jamie launches a quick counter-attack. Yeah. The move puts Exiles 5-3 up.
5-3, it's a very important goal, just before the end of the third session.
They are shooting with new confidence. Exiles go into the final quarter with a 2-goal lead. They need to keep their heads.
Time out, go back!
But Exiles fail to clear the ball.
Ball under!
And Sirens score.
There is an empty player in the middle. Don't hold the ball.
Tamás wants more goals to cement Exile's fragile lead. And he gets one.
Yeah! Long corner shot, I told you. Jamie, thank you. Bravo. Go, go, go.
Luca has found a great centre-forward position. The shot is saved, but he has already done enough. Exiles have won their first game in 2 years.
We played as a team, as not individual players, but we played as a whole team, and this was the result.
Amazing game. I think as a team, the score could have even been better.
That help from an Olympic champion with all that experience really helped us.
We won. We trashed them. We can do it all over again.
You did very well from the beginning to the end, and you can see the result came. Congratulations. I hope you will continue this way because you are a good team.
We showed them that we can play. You showed yourselves that you can win. Well done. Well done. One, two, three.
I'm really pleased that the few things I told them, I could see on the game as well. The scoreboard was 6 next to our name and 4 only next to Sirens. We won. I'm very happy.
Great start of a really long, happy future for Exiles.